I'm in a big spaceship. Pete Donaldson here for Absolute Radio. I'm joined by, the guys from Kasabian, Tom.
Hi.
How are you doing? You all right?
Hello.
Yeah,
good. Are you?
We played the single for the first time last night. Went down very well indeed with the people texting in and tweeting and stuff like that. The taste of macaroni on a seafood stick.
Yes.
I don't think crab sticks have been discussed at length in rock and roll.
It's Tom's fault.
That. My fault, yeah. I love crab sticks. Serge ate some, you know. So that is
a big
my
fan
fault.
Of the surimi paste? Is that the fish they put in it?
I don't know what they put in it. I just like loads of vinegar
cod.
And pepper on them in a bowl.
Pepper,
and it's drenched in vin and malt vinegar.
and it is the tracks I've heard from the album. It's a joyous album. I mentioned this just before we started recording. It's a lot of fun because you guys are known for getting a bit, you know, down and dark.
Oh, very serious.
This time it's a bit more. It's a celebration, isn't it?
That period in sort of the 70s and you know, a golden period of guitar music was made with melody and songs. Crafted songs, and that's kind of the idea was to sort of make a really good guitar album with you know, great tunes on it.
There's a lot more love in this album, I think, compared to the previous one.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then you get 24/7, and the swagger's back.
Yeah, you know, we need one. But yeah, it's a real positive, sort of feel good album. Mm.
And are you guys feeling good at the moment, I guess?
We're all right. We're in and out. We're jet lagged, so like we hit a wall, don't we? But I said to Serge, we're really like buzzing early because, like, you know, radio playing, it's out. You're in Love with Psychos out, and Leicester City being drawn in, you know, in Champions League.
I've had to go Madrid, I believe.
Yeah, it's all too much sometimes.
It's too much information.
Yeah, it's too much. And it's Paddy's Day as well, so you know what I mean? So
there's
a lot going on, ain't
there? There is, yeah.
Have you played with a band sort of in the last couple of years and thought, wow?
I suppose, like, when we toured with Oasis, you know, that was a massive, like, it's quite surreal when you're on stage at Wembley, you know, opening up for them boys.
Yeah.
That was pretty massive.
That was amazing, yeah. Good times.
Yeah.
and it's been, don't remember a lot of it, but.
No, they're some of the happiest moments of our lives, I mean. I mean, because you got to remember, like, you know, they were our idols and stuff. So just being with them and stuff was great, you know. There were great days, weren't there?
Mm. Oh, yeah.
We were only young, you see.
Yeah.
Puppies. You know.
And you look forward to getting out and playing the songs live. Is there a particular song on the album that you're really looking forward to having the crowd sing along to?
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot easier proposition, this one, to figure out. Like, you know, previous albums of sort of like a jigsaw puzzle of how the hell are we going to do this?
I can't put that on a guitar pedal.
No, it is. We're like rehearsals. I'm like, how are we doing this? How are we going to do it? Like,
we're sticking on Pro Tools.
You know, honestly, God.
So this one is like, well, it's in D. Come on, yeah. What's the next chord? We've got that. Oh, okay, we can play that. That's
okay,
great.
Right.
Let's just put that out. So yeah, it's been a lot easier. But I think, like, you know, obviously the first single, the lead single, is pretty. Going to be fun. I think, like, El Rey is going to be ridiculous, and then Acid House is probably going to be.
We've got to learn those, haven't we?
Thankfully, it's a lot easier.
Acid House is going to be the next single, I believe.
That's what we think.
We look at the money men behind the camera who know what's going on.
Money men.
Your good mate Noel Fielding is on Great British Bake Off now. Are you excited for the lad? That was a bit of a swerve, wasn't it?
Yeah. No, we spoke about it. We figured that, you know, like Salvador Dali did a Cadbury's chocolate advert one year.
Yeah. All the big ones.
Well, yeah, it's like one of the characters that made it all right. No, I think, you know what? He's such a gentle, beautiful kind of soul, and in that environment, you know, I think he's going to be wonderful, you know. And
it's
a mad time.
Noel's amazing. People are sick of poor Hollywood, ain't they? Do you know what I mean?
So, on it.
Sake.
Right. But well, at least you'll be all fair with the show once your friend's on there, I guess.
Exactly.
I won't be invited to that show, will I?
If you guys could host any TV show, what would it be?
This Is Your Life. It's massive. Yeah, you know, to get all these people you've not seen for millions of years. I mean, and then you go, oh, do you remember him and her? And you're like, oh, wow, what are you doing here? And let's talk about your life, wow.
You guys are playing with Eminem and Muse at Reading Festival. It's 5 years since your last headline appearance there.
Is it?
Yeah, man. Yeah. You know, we went to Reading as kids and you know, that poster, that yellow poster.
Yeah.
And now I've actually got it up. And, you know, many things I keep. That poster I got and framed it, you know, because it meant so much.
I went back and watched it and I forgot that you did the Corgis cover.
Yeah, it was such a mad choice.
A mad choice.
No, it was great. I got no idea why I did it. I did, you know, Scatman. Remember that song, Scatman?
Yeah.
threw a little Scatman out on the mic. I sort of, I think what I was trying to do, you know the Freddie Mercury thing. I was sort of, his tongue in cheek.
Yeah.
And he did that, and the whole Wembley sing it back. And I thought, oh, you know what, that's a good idea. And as it's leaving my mouth, I'm going, this could be bad. Literally, no one could be like, what? Everyone would be like, Tim Hatchett, you're going, what's he doing? I'm not doing that. And thankfully, they all did it back. Oh, that could have gone so horrible. Like, what's he doing Scatman for? But no, they all sing it back. So I won't be doing Scatman again.
I do wonder what you know, when the lead singer pops off and you take over. What does the singer do?
What do you do?
Do you have a cup of tea? Do you do a poo?
What's a myth? It's just you imagine. You think in your own mind what you'd like to think.
Right. Okay.